Well, hi there. It's Inktober day two, and today's prompt was scurry. And I'm not going to lie, as soon as I saw this one, my mind did go blank for a second or two. And then suddenly I thought of a mouse. So that's the first thing I drew, just from memory. It's not fantastic. I haven't ever drawn a mouse before. And I was trying to link what the mouse could go with. So my initial thought was a cat. So that's kind of the vibe that I went for this one. I thought about doing just a cat and a mouse, and that would kind of be scurry. The cat doesn't look great here, and maybe I should have looked at a reference for this, but this is just a quick thumbnail. So the idea that I had was basically going from grey to black to white and trying to just get different shades with the ink. I also just redrew a cat here just to check I could actually draw a cat. And that was, I don't know if that was helpful or not in the slightest, but I wanted to try and get some different shades out of the ink today. So the idea was to have a really clear distinction between the background, the cat, and then the mouse. And I thought that would kind of represent scurry quite well. So I thought I would work from the outside to in. So the first thing I did was wet the background and try to add ink in the background, and this was supposed to be grey because I knew I wanted the cat to be black. Now unfortunately, as you can kind of see here, the paper dried really quickly when I wet it. I think partly because it was in the sun, it just really dried really quickly, so the ink didn't exactly blend everywhere and it doesn't exactly look very grey. Unfortunately, I don't know if that's partly the paper choice, that it just didn't stay wet for very long, but also because it was sunny, it dried so fast. And then as that was drying, obviously I couldn't move on to the cat because it would just smudge everywhere, so I moved on to the mouse next. And the mouse I wanted to keep really quite white, but I had to get some detail down, so unfortunately the mouse ended up being quite a bit more grey than I had hoped. I wanted the mouse to be a little bit more white, but then I moved on to the cat. Now I wanted the cat to be black just because, I mean, a lot of cats are black, and that was just my initial thought really with India ink. Rather than doing grey, I thought it'd be a bit more obvious that it was a cat. I do think the eyes should have been a lot further down. I don't know why I did them so high. And it kind of looks like the cat's wearing a mask right now, but it does kind of sort itself out. I also think I probably could have shaped the ears a little bit better and maybe looked at a reference. I just kind of went with this one and I was like, I know what a cat looks like, and evidently not. This is how the cat went. The cat was really, just one flat wash of black really. But I do quite like how with the India ink, really, it goes opaque so easily. And I mean, it's probably because it's liquid in comparison to something like watercolour. And I guess if you use watercolour straight from the tube, you've got a higher chance of getting that opacity from the offset. But with the ink, it was really lovely how just within one wash, it was just completely black. It was very opaque. And I do think as well, that's probably why ink is so much faster, because you can get it opaque so easily. And ink, in my experience, which is very limited, but so far, it doesn't seem like it needs too many layers. And I really like that about it. It also dries so fast because I was able to add the cat and it didn't smudge really at all. You can see it smudged a little bit on the right side near the ear, but it didn't smudge very much at all, and I didn't really allow it to dry for very long, so that was obviously a bonus. The mouse ended up being quite a bit more grey than I had intended, but then I grabbed a gel pen and tried to add a load of whiskers, and I'm not sure about this. I think I might have gone a little bit overboard with the gel pen. Sometimes I have to keep the gel pen away from me because I will just go in and add way too much, and this is one of those instances. I think I did way too many whiskers. I also added some on the kind of eyebrows, I guess, of the cat, which like cats do have, but it wasn't exactly essential with a very white gel pen, I think. So I'm not sure if this exactly worked, but this was a very quick one. As I said, I've sped this one up, but this probably, I mean, it took me less than an hour to do all of the planning and everything for this one. And I'm somewhat happy with the background, but I found it very difficult to control, so that's something that I really want to work on in the future. I'm quite happy with the eyes, but I'm not sure the anatomy is correct. I think they should be a bit lower, and I do think the mouse in itself is quite cute. But yeah, this is what I have created for Scurry. It's definitely a learning experience. This is only day two of Inktober, so hopefully as time progresses, I can get more experience. And I'm really hoping that when I have a flick through this sketchbook, there's actually gonna be improvement that can be seen, and hopefully the practice will actually lead to some improvement and we can flick through the sketchbook and actually see that I get a bit better at controlling it. I then obviously added some splatters. I thought the background was a bit bare and I really like splatters, but because it's ink it kind of made a mess everywhere, and because it's not watercolor it didn't wash off very easily, so I probably wouldn't recommend that. And here it is. Thanks for watching.